Well, you'll notice where this shore mat should pit on the drop, which means the end of the cast. It's one of the most challenging situations. Why? Because most of the time we're not anticipating that to happen. When we cast our jigs, we are physically and mentally prepared to wait for the jig to hit the bottom. 99 out of 100 times, that is what happens. The jig finds the bottom. The off chance of that jig finding its way into a fluke's mouth is what we are not always prepared for. Meaning, are you in the position to set the hook forcefully? Is your drag set right? From my experience, some of the biggest fluke bite on the drop. So before you chuck your jig out, make sure you're mentally and physically prepared for a lifetime fish. Enjoy. This fish measured around 25 and a half inches, a true beast all around. After fishing for several years, the only thing that really keeps me going is pursuing these prize-worthy fluke from shore. And let me emphasize again that these are very rare opportunities. Catching multiples of these shore mats require a bit more than simple luck. It combines your technique with your ability to understand the conditions around the place you fish to maximize your chances. Hey Siri, what time is it? Don't you think? Yeah. Water. Oh, I got another. Oh, here, Dave. Here. Oh, yeah. Here it is. Yeah. I shot it because I caught it close to the lip. Yeah. Yeah, little tiny one. The ones on the lip are pretty small. It's the big ones are in the deep. They're like, oh.